Hello, in this video I'm gonna review a filament from Polymaker called PolyMide. It's a two-fold filament, PA6 glass fiber or carbon fiber. So it's a two filament samples I received from them. And I'm gonna have a look at that filament. So let's have a look after the intro. So I'm going to state for this filament review, I just received this filament without any cost. They sent me this sample for review and no money exchange hand. But having a look at this filament, it's a nylon based filament with glass fibers, and the other sample is with carbon fiber. And this PolyMide is a new type of filament. The print temperature for both filaments is around 280 to 300 C, so it's a high temp material. Bed should be 60 degrees, and fan should be off. So as it is a nylon filament, it's sensitive to moisture, and I just printed out the material straight from the sample bag. It was a sealed bag. And if you have this filament, you should dry it out before using. But I spent quite a time printing out layer adhesion samples to compare layer adhesion compared to other filaments. And you can see here in my filament box, it's a quite number of break tests. I print them out and break them apart in my break test machine and measure the force needed to pull the filament apart. So the machine basically pulls the filament apart to see how much effort it's needed to pull it apart. And for nylon filament, it performed really great. I was really happy with the layer adhesion for both filaments. So having a look at the few prints I did, here's a maker coin. This is the glass fiber filament, that's a lighter color, and the dark color is a carbon fiber filament. I can't remember what happened here, if I ran out of filament at this point, maybe with this print. But looking at the filament, there's a little bit of like blobs and strings, and I think that's just because of the moisture in the filament. I needed maybe to dry it out before I print it. I could see that with some of the prints, there were some stringing issues, and that's typical for nylon that isn't perfectly dried. So I think that's just my fault, but those prints that I was testing out, like overhang test here, it's a 70 degree overhang that came out really nice, and with no cooling, part cooling fan, there's no issues. You could expect some drooping issues, but this was giving me excellent results. The same with the carbon fiber, that came out excellent as well. So underside of the overhang, the 70 degrees overhang. So the 70 degree overhang came out excellent for both filaments. You can see the carbon fiber part is a little bit cleaner on the top part. I think this is because of moisture, there's some stringing issue. I did a bridging test, and with no fan, it's a difficult test. And for nylon print, this became a difficult one for all nylons, but printing at 295 degrees, getting those bridging results here with the carbon fiber, it's a little bit better. You see the bridging has some issues, but still the top side looks great. You can see here the top sides look great, but the underside has a little bit of problem. And then printed out some mechanical parts, like this is a fixture that I use to hold my headphones on an oven, and this is really stable, and this is like a mechanical print like this, and here's a like a bracket as well that I printed. It bends to some degree, but it's quite stiff. So mechanical parts like this is where this filament shines. Here's a like a cover for a lens, that I printed. This is the upper side of it. You can see how smooth the top layer is. This is the bottom layer on my Prusa printer, but you can see how smooth the top surface is. This is really, you can flex it somewhat like a nylon, but it's much stiffer than a pure nylon. So this is where this filament shines. Here's another part. It's mechanically durable. There are some other test prints that I did, like laying down on the bed. This is like a break test. It's really difficult to break. This was the glass fiber. I even cut myself doing it. And this is carbon fiber. I actually can't break this one. This is too strong. So it's extremely strong. Normally I can break those tests. I printed like a carabiner as well. This is quite strong. Here's some clip. So all those mechanical parts you can see here, this is really where this filament shines. Here's a bottom cover with the carbon fiber. It's extremely durable. So for mechanical applications, this filament is performing excellent. And maybe just in the finer details, this was caused by the moisture in the filament. Still, you can see here in the maker coin, the letters came out somewhat okay, but I think those blobs are just moisture issues. It wasn't apparent on the carbon fiber material. I started to print with the carbon fiber and then moved to the glass fiber. So maybe I had the glass fiber laying around in the environment for too long, but that's my fault, not fault of the filament. And here's one clip as well. You can see the stringing, but it's easily cleaned up, so it's not like a big issue. So as you could see from the mechanical parts, they are looking really clean and extremely strong and durable. It's very difficult to break the test samples that I normally can break with my hands. So layer adhesion is really good. I did quite a lot of testing on that and toughness of the filament. For a nylon, it has some flex to it, but because of the fiber, carbon fiber and glass fiber, it's stiffer than just pure nylon. So I think this PolyMide filament is a really good engineering filament. And like, if you have mechanical applications, this is something you should have a look at and see if it's a fit for you. So I was quite happy to get this sample to try it out. You really need to have a printer with an all metal hot end and a hard end nozzle for this filament. It's not like an everyday use filament for normal applications like PLA or PET. So you need to take that into consideration. But if you have the application for this mechanical prints, then I think this filament is a quite good option. So you could have a look at Polymaker's website and have a look. So I was at least quite happy to be able to get this sample. And like I mentioned, this was sent to me without any cost for me. Just came in the mail. But this will be it for this video. I hope you like what I'm doing here on the channel, and maybe you should consider subscribing. I'm doing all sorts of stuff on the channel. But for now, I thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next one.